Good afternoon. I'm Chris Moore, a senior scientist with the Chesapeake Bay Foundation, and I work out of our Virginia office. This week, one of the species that we wanted to talk about was the mummichog. You may have never heard about the mummichog. It's not one of the species that you commonly hear us talk about at the Chesapeake Bay Foundation. Obviously, you hear us talk a lot about striped bass, oysters, blue crab, menhaden, things like that. But in some ways, like menhaden, a mummichog is actually a food fish for lots of other species that are out there, like striped bass at times, redfish, summer flounder, and for blue heron especially. Mummichog is a small species of the killifish family. They grow in tidal estuaries like we are here at today. This is actually Wolf Snare Creek, which runs into the eastern branch of the Lynn Haven River down in Virginia Beach. And mummichogs live in these kind of muddy salt marsh habitats. They're very unique in that they can actually burrow into the mud. Another name for mummichog is mud minnow. When it gets really cold, or also sometimes when you have a really high tide and mummichogs get caught in an area when the tide goes out, so they can burrow down and wait for the tide to come back as well. So mummichogs are really important because they feed so many other species, and they travel in big schools through the marshes, and it's really common to see them in the summertime traveling in those big schools. And the mummichog is actually a Native American word for a fish that swims in a big school. We're in Wolf Snare Creek, which is off the Lynn Haven River, and like I say, this is pretty common mummichug habitat. You've got salt marsh out here, you've got the tidal Lynn Haven River, which in this area is still pretty salty. You'd have oysters and things like that not too far away. But mummichugs are usually found in these habitats, and they're actually fairly easy to catch. Most people put over what's called a minnow pot, and you can bait it with all sorts of different things. One of the easiest things is dog food, but you can also use crabs and clams and things like that. But you tend to set the minnow pot for a couple hours and come back, and hopefully you've caught a few mummichogs. So we're going to see what we've got here. And that's a good sound. You can kind of hear them jumping around in there. So we're going to take a look here just to show you kind of how this works. There's two pieces to this minnow pot, and it's kind of like a funnel on each end. So the mummichogs, they sense there's bait in there, and then they can actually swim through the holes on either end. And then what happens is once they actually get caught inside, they can't find the holes to get back out. So we're going to release these guys in a few minutes, but they'll definitely work for us for now. So we've got a male mummichog here. You can see that, like a lot of killifish, they kind of have the bands down them, down the side of the fish. Not a real big fish. It's definitely a species in the minnow family. One thing that you can see with these mummichogs very clearly is they're another of our bay species that actually has countershading. You may ask, what does countershading mean? That basically means that they tend to be darker on top and lighter on the bottom. And so what that does is, if it's a predator who's looking down from the sky, like a blue heron, or maybe a fish swimming above them, they kind of look like the bottom and they're camouflaged. If you're a fish like a flounder that really likes to eat mummichogs, then if that fish is looking up, they see that lighter area up above them, and therefore they can't see the individual fish. But here we have a pregnant female. You can see the big belly there. Mummichogs are great in that they can produce lots of eggs throughout the year. Most mummichogs, we think, actually spawn 8 different times throughout the year, and so they are highly reproductive. And even if a lot of them are being eaten by various predators and things like that, they can replenish areas very well. Another great thing about mummichogs is they're good what we call biosentinels. What does that mean? That basically means they're good indicators of habitat quality being good or bad. Mummichogs never range very far from where they're born. In some cases, it's less than about 50 yards. And so any toxins or things like that are out in the environment, they will pick up. And if we study those animals, we'll know if they've picked up those toxins in the environment. On the flip side, when we do restoration projects that improve habitat and get rid of chemical contaminants and things like that, mummichogs are a great way to go back and study those later. And then we can find out if we've done a good job removing those chemical contaminants that we've been trying to remove, and we have succeeded in creating a healthier environment. Mummichogs are really unique because they were the first fish to actually go up into space. In 1973, as part of the Skylab experiments, not only did they take two mummichogs into space, but they also took 50 eggs with them in order to, one, see how fish did in space, but also test how new hatchlings of fish would do in space. Mummichogs are one of the most common species you'll find in your local tackle shop. They're usually sold as minnows, and if you go look in there, you'll see the big schools of mud minnows, mummichogs, swimming around. They do that for a couple different reasons. One, because they're really hardy species, so they survive well in the tanks that the bait and tackle shops have. But also, they serve as great bait for so many different species. One of the classic examples is a lot of mud minnows or mummichogs are bought every year to fish for summer flounder, which is one of the most popular species to fish for, especially in the lower and the middle portions of Chesapeake Bay. So I hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit more about the mummichog. Although it's a small critter in our estuarine environments, it has many, many important purposes. It serves as bait for lots of other fish species and bird species. It's a great bioindicator that tells us how healthy our watersheds are. And kind of unique, it was the first fish to hitch a ride into space. Have a great day.